go.
Good evening, everybody.
Tonight, the shock system. Not just Inca Block, but KIF as well. I'm going to show you the history, maybe even a bit of the future. We are looking at one specific detail of a watch movement. And that is the balance wheel. This is the balance wheel, and it's just like the pendulum of a clock. That's the bit that says tick-tock and is keeping a watch on time. The balance wheel is just like a pendulum in a clock. But there is a huge problem in a balance wheel, and that's has been the same problem for, again, at least 200 years. And that's this. This is a pocket watch, and still the balance is huge, heavy, and has to be moving freely, isochronism. But the detail, just the tiniest detail we are going to talk about tonight is this bit over here. There is nothing in this pocket watch movement. And in this beautiful, we are going to just talk about this little detail there. And trust me, it is fascinating. Because the huge disadvantage of the balance wheel is it has to move freely, but with hardly any friction. There can be no friction. So the axle or pivot it is moving on has to be tiny, really, really, really small. And here is a model of a pivot. This is the model Richard made, because the original size is this. This is a normal one from a pocket watch, so in our terms it's huge still. But now it's easier to show you the workings of the balance staff. And if you're really into this and want to know a bit more, there is a video about the balance staff and how to replace it here on the YouTube channel. But what I want to show you is these pivots. There and here, even smaller. They have to be tiny, so there is no friction during the movement. So the pivots, the axle, is tiny. But the balance wheel itself is huge. If you think that just about this this balance staff is here in the middle, that's straight up. So the balance wheel is riveted around here. Then you see the balance wheel is huge and heavy, but the pivot is tiny and delicate and small and of hardened steel, so a bit more brittle than the normal carbon steel. So it's a balance. You want the tiniest pivot. In the perfect world, you don't want a pivot. So in the most modern watches, there's the balance wheel is moving in a magnetic field, so there are no pivots. But still, the pivot itself, you want as small as possible to reduce friction. And the balance wheel has to be heavy to get the isochronism, the movement. So that's a balance. And that's a real Achilles heel of the pocket watch. Because if you bang it, an impact, you drop it, or if there's a bang, if you drop the movement, the tiny pivots will break immediately. And that is a huge problem. Especially for pocket watches, but look at this. Every given moment here in the workshop, we have at least one, well, we call it mariage watches. and that's a wristwatch, but with a pocket watch movement. Well, there you see the balance wheel, and we have just fitted, well, Edwin did, just fitted a new balance staff because the tiny pivot is broken. A pocket watch movement, which this is not prepared for impact, no shock system. Shock system, banging, dropping. So be careful when you want or buy a mariage watch. It is a pocket watch movement, and a pocket watch you wear on your body, in your waistcoat, and you don't bang your body too easily. Trust me, you don't. But your wrist is much more dynamic. You can bang your wrist. You don't bang your body against anything. So a pocket watch doesn't have to be, it's not too much of a problem if it hasn't got a shock system. But if you put the pocket watch movement on your wrist, it is a problem. So at any given time, there's always a mariage watch here, which needs a new pivot. So beautiful watches. If you like them, please do. Nothing wrong with it. But please allow some room in your budget for every once in a while a new balance staff, because it is going to happen. So nothing wrong with mariage watches, but just a word of warning. We are in a moment in history, 1948, that Inca block was invented. And this is a nice model. It says KIF, but it's just about the same as Inca block. And this was revolutionary in 1948. To make it even a stranger story, I'm going to show you in a moment a pocket watch from, I think, the 1820s to 40s, and it's already in there. So it already existed for at least 100 years. I even think 150 years, just about, give and take. I know there are many exceptions, but just as a rule of thumb. The idea was already there for at least 150 years, but just about 1948. Again, it's just about that era, just after the Second World War. Inca block, which is a product name, a manufacturer, but now we call usually the shock system Inca block. But Inca block is just one manufacturer of many. Inca block started in 38. Thank you. But I think it was in the mainstream watches from 1948. Yeah, Harry Otter, I agree. Before 19 or pre 48, hardly any shock system. And then they came with revolutionary idea. And still just about unchanged until now. And I would like to show you this. This is, once you see it and once you understand it, so basic and simple and, well, that you think, well, is it that brilliant? Because it is quite simple. But the way to simplicity, that is the genius. So I'm going to show you how, well, this is KIF, but how Inca Block, how DiaShock from Seiko, there are many, 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 and they just about work all the same. Okay, well, the basics of the shock system. And again, once you see it and once you understand, it is so simple, but please try to remember that the simplicity is the genius. Here we have the balance wheel. And here are the tiny pivots of, here are the tiny pivots of the balance staff. That I hope that makes sense, right? You don't need too much imagination to see this. Tiny pivots and a real heavy balance wheel. And now the genius. When you look from the top, there in the balance wheel, you see the tiniest of springs. There it is. And those are all have a patent. And Inca Block, that spring is so well commonly known that everybody recognizes the Inca Block spring, but different manufacturers have different springs. I will show you in a moment. The shape of that spring is so well known that you see it everywhere once you look at it. So, back to the drawing board. Here is the pivot. The pivot and the balance staff. The big and heavy balance ring. And here the tiniest spring we just saw from the top. So that's a spring and that is a spring. All the red parts are ruby. And if you into the rubies and the jewels and how that works, there's another video on our YouTube channel. So please have a look at that. And this is just brass. So those two springs, that spring and that spring, make sure that everything is compressed, but have some give because it's a spring. Look at this. The balance wheel can move. And if it's just in the normal action, here's the end shake, tiny bit of end shake. End shake is this. If it's just moving and working on your wrist, it is like this. So during an impact, the balance wheel, the heavy balance wheel, can move just a bit. And now there are several genius details in the shock system. The first is, and the most important, if there's an impact and the big heavy balance wheel have a moment of inertia, look at this, then there is movement in here. And then during impact, look at this, the big heavy impact is cushioned here on the balance staff. And that is the real wide bit, so the strong bit of the balance staff. So all the force of impact is in here and not in the tiny pivot. Do you see? During impact, this is happening. The white bit is touching the blue bit and the pivot just stays intact. There is no real deformation of the pivot. And same to the other side. And if the impact is gone, the two springs keep everything compact. And due to these slopes, there and there, do you see that? they always get back in the center. Cusps, it did cost a fortune, definitely. So, due to this slope, they always go back centered. And the watch will keep running. And that is genius. So the pivots are protected. And if the impact is gone, everything is back to normal again. And the watch will keep running without losing time. And that is so important for the normal function of a mechanical watch on your wrist and not on your body. And that's the difference between a wristwatch and a pocket watch, is this shock system and how it keeps running after impact. So the small springs there make sure that impact is cushioned on the place here of the balance staff where it can resist the force instead of breaking. I hope that makes sense, and if you have any questions, please let me know.